Welcome to Maryland's Coast Adventures. Welcome to Maryland's Coast Adventure. I'm Dawn Eamon, your host, and we have another fantastic show. First, we're going to check out Country's Calling Festival with all the fantastic artists coming to our town. And next up, we're going to head to Frontier Town to see the fall events they have to offer. So stay tuned.
Welcome to Maryland's Coast Adventures, brought to you by Worcester County, Maryland's Coast Naturally Cool, and by Ocean City, Maryland, somewhere to smile about.
I'm here with Jimmy Charles, and one of the artists performing here at Country's Calling. Jimmy,
yes.
This is such a great opportunity. We're here in your hometown. We go back. We used to work together when you were, I think, 14 years old, and I won't say how old I was. But how do you feel about performing here at Country's Calling?
It's so exciting. The town is just buzzing, electric. I'm getting so many messages I can't even keep up of so many people that are going to come, and they're coming early to make sure they get to the Scoot stage, which I see right over there. This is my first time seeing it. So
great. That's exciting.
Yeah, so everybody's so excited, and it's just... I'm gonna try to get through. I think I'm gonna get a little emotional because I've been on big stages before, but I think there's just gonna be so much hometown love here, and I'm gonna feel that and give it back. It's gonna be exhilarating.
And it's
sure.
1 o'clock tomorrow, which is Friday.
Scoot stage.
Yeah, the
but
scoot
get
stage.
Early because you don't want to think you can just walk right in there. There might be a line. You want to go get a hat and it's a Maryland thing T-shirt at the merch table real quick, and then get to the stage.
So how did you get into the music industry?
Oh, my dad. You know, dad growing up in Ocean City, he loved Jimmy Buffett. Of course, he loved Merle Haggard and George Jones and so many of the old school guys. So, three chords of the truth, my dad instilled. None of my friends around here were listening to it at that time. Country has certainly grown in Maryland.
Evolved,
it's huge
for sure.
Now.
Yes.
But back then, it really wasn't that big. But he brought me back to the roots of country music. So, eventually it brought me to Nashville. So I've been in Nashville for 13 years or more now. It's been a crazy wild ride, but I started writing songs when I was 16, just off those first three chords, and then it's progressed from there. So
I was curious, what's your inspiration when you actually put pen to paper? Is it the beat first? Is it the thought first?
Always looking for a hook, Always in life experiences, they happen, and I'm just like, that's a song. Like my new one coming up, A Boy and His Dog. We just got a new puppy. I saw that relationship.
Adorable.
I remember my Chesapeake Chocolate Lab growing up and how loyal and faithful he is. So I wrote a song about that. You Were There, which I'm going to sing tomorrow, is a song of gratitude, thanking everybody. And it was just, it was life experiences, where I am. I normally try to correlate it with something that's in life, but usually it comes with a thought or something I want to write about. And a lot of times I'll get with co-writers in Nashville who are incredible. They write constantly. They'll write three or four songs a day, every day. That's their job. They don't sing. Some of them are terrible singers. Not all of them, but some of them. They'll admit it to you too. They'll be like, you don't want to hear me sing. But they are so great with words, and really we sit down and we put this thought into a song. And usually in three hours or so we come out with just a beautiful story or something, and if it makes the cut, we take it to the shop, the recording studio.
Fantastic. So besides this festival here, where are other places people can see you play? I know recently you had some exciting news. I'd love you to share that and about that.
Yeah, I'm so excited. It's a dream come true that I partnered with the USO. So that's something I've always wanted to do. And I was at an event, and someone knew someone, and I sang the anthem there. And those dreams came true. The other day I got to go to Fort Campbell and tour the entire base. They took us around, and I got to sing to the troops there. They also had me rappel off like this huge tower, and I about lost it.
Awesome. That's a great
experience. But I made it. I was like, oh my gosh. Like when you get up, but now I feel like I can do it because I'm like, oh, okay.
So it's like skydiving?
Yeah, but I mean, it's just a rope. And
you're coming down
you
the side of the building.
You can see don't look down. Once I looked up, so. But I've conquered my fears there, and I think there's going to be a lot of other amazing moments.
You'll be going overseas to see the
Yeah, wow. So that's one of the things. So we're starting off in different bases in America and so different events. You know, when the troops come home, they throw them a welcoming party. Mm-hmm. How cool is it that I get to be a part of that? I love our military. We have so much to be thankful. Freedom is not free. I've always loved Toby Keith, mm-hmm. and you know what he's done for the troops and the USO and more. I mean, I forget exactly how many troops. It's more than anybody has ever done. So God rest his soul. We miss him, but I'm happy to you know, to do what I can and give the troops and their families. You know, USO is very much about not only the troops themselves, but the families, because they make a lot of sacrifices as well.
Will you give us a little, like, inside scoop? How many songs are you playing? What are you starting off with?
Blue Spaces is my go-to intro. Blue Spaces, then Country Up. I actually have a Spotify playlist of the exact, except for Brought to You by Tequila, which is not recorded yet, but I am recording that one.
So you can look on Spotify. So you're playing a song that's not out, any new songs that are not out officially?
Brought to You by Tequila, and I'm gonna do a special Boy and His Dog acoustically.
Oh, I love that.
Bring the dog up here. We gotta bring Nelson up here.
So this was your inspiration for a boy, and he has a son, Charleston.
A boy and his dog.
And his dog.
He's just like a little teddy bear.
Well, how do you think he's gonna do with the crowd? Will he eat it up?
Yeah, he's not gonna be on there. He's definitely gonna take some stages. He's still a puppy, so I think he's 6 months or less right now. So we'll wait. We don't want to put him through too much. Plus, we're gonna be partying afterwards, so we don't have to worry about the dog. We're gonna be watching backstage for all these other
great artists.
So, but yeah, boy and his dog. I had a dog growing up, and it reminded me of that. And then, of course, I was able to give this to my little boy, and just watching them together, there's just something special about it, you know.
The bond, right?
The bond of any girl or boy, you know. So, I'm gonna sing this acoustically tomorrow. Let the band take a break, and because they've only heard it like once. It's not even finished yet. So I think it's going to be a special moment.
That's awesome. So I can't wait to see you tomorrow. Congratulations on this huge hometown experience here. We hope you all check out Country's Calling, and Jimmy is on the Scoot stage at 1 p.m. tomorrow.
Woohoo!
Be sure to follow Maryland's Coast Adventures on Facebook and Instagram to keep up with the latest adventures. Just search Maryland's Coast Adventures and join in the fun.
Whatever the season, you'll surely have the time of your life in Ocean City. Golfers will find 17 area championship golf courses, including Ocean City's own Eagles Landing. Ocean City Golf Club features a totally redesigned and rebuilt Newport Bay course. Rum Point overlooks Assateague Island National Seashore and Assiniboine Bay. Lighthouse Sound offers a great variety in terms of both its great visual excitement and strategy. The newest addition to the Ruark Golf family is the Glen Riddle Golf Club. Baywood Greens offers golfers the most scenic and spectacular golf on the Delmarva Peninsula. Delaware's premier golf course is the Bayside Resort Golf Club. Bear Trap Dunes Golf Club offers one of the area's most unique and memorable golf experiences on the Eastern Shore. Ocean Pines Golf and Country Club is home to the Delmarva Peninsula's only championship golf course designed by the legendary Robert Trent Jones Sr.
Ocean City, Maryland. Great golf is just the beginning.
If you want your trade-in to be worth more down the road, then shop Toyota. The best resale value brand, according to Kelley Blue Book's KBB.com, for the third year in a row. On a $45,000 vehicle, see how these Toyotas are predicted to be worth thousands more than the average vehicle after the first 5 years of ownership. That's performance you can count on. Shop local inventory on buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Book your next trip in beautiful Maryland's coast. Stroll the downtown streets and enjoy shopping locally in Pocomoke City, Snow Hill, and Berlin. Dine at farm-to-table restaurants or enjoy the nightlife throughout Ocean City. Looking for outdoor adventure? Reserve your tee time at one of the 17 championship golf courses. Take a ride through Assateague Island National Seashore to view the wild ponies or camp in the Pocomoke River State Forest. Visit the serene landscape and be immersed in nature throughout Worcester County, Maryland. Start planning your trip today.
Welcome back to Maryland's Coast Adventures. I'm Dawn Eamon, your host, and I am here with Tom Perlazzo, Director of Tourism and Business Development for the town of Ocean City. We're so excited, Tom. We have the first Country's Calling. How do you feel about that? I think you had a big help in bringing the event here.
Absolutely. I'm really excited. First time event, you know, it's in October. It's a great opportunity to showcase Ocean City in the off season. you know, hopefully folks come back for summer vacation or whatever they want to do. But great weekend, great weather planned, great entertainment. We've got something for everyone here.
Yeah, full lineup all day Friday, all day Saturday. Plenty of artists, variety. You can visit all the places on the boardwalk. So how did this event start to, you know, establish? I know we have Oceans Calling that happened last weekend, and then this year you tacked on this one.
Well, we, you know, we were after C3 for many, I guess, a couple of years since I've been here to try to bookend some events. We were lucky enough to talk him into doing a second event using the same footprint. You know, obviously he can save a little money and, you know, we can keep the assets up in place. So we picked the country genre and here we are. So we're really excited about it. Again, it's a great economic catalyst for Ocean City and it does everything it's supposed to do, I can assure you that.
It's an opportunity to be on the beach with the ocean by your side, see some of your favorite artists, and I actually came to Ocean's Calling. Super easy to get in, to eat, find a drink. You can go on the rides, that's in your ticket price. I also biked home, which was simple. Transportation was super easy in and out.
Yeah, it's amazing. You know, this is a kind of a small city that was built on the beach, and you know, it's an icon. You have your iconic boardwalk in the background. You can take advantage of all those businesses. As you mentioned, we've got Jolly Rogers and a pier. All the rides are free. You can create a great experience in here, and you've got the best country music in the U.S., so really excited.
And it's a sold-out event, right?
Sold-out event. We sold 55,000 tickets, probably sold out in 10 minutes. So we know it's going to be good.
And like he said earlier, the weather is beautiful, 70 degrees, sunny, nice breeze coming off the ocean. So I'm super excited about it. Congrats to you for bringing Ocean's Calling and a new one, Country's Calling, to the town of Ocean City.
Well, thank you. We got a great team, I will tell you. Thanks to everyone out there to make this extremely successful. You know, we couldn't do it. You know, I always say it takes a village sometimes to get something done. But, you know, every department in the city, including, you know, just having permission from Mayor and City Council to do this, you know, has been a win-win for our community. And be on the lookout for some other good things coming.
Thank you, Tom, for your time.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us to hear all about Country's Calling and Ocean's Calling. Hearing how Jimmy Charles got involved in the music industry and how Tom Perlazzo brought those amazing events to the town of Ocean City. Next up, we're head to Frontier Town to hear about their fall events. Welcome back. I'm here with Meredith Birch at Frontier Town, and we are here the weekend before Halloween. Meredith, what is happening this weekend? I know that driving in, there were a lot of cars. There's a lot of people coming in, so I'm sure there's so many events to be excited about.
There's so many good things happening this weekend. We are right now at our haunted trail. It's Friday night. We've got the outside public coming. We've got our Frontier Town guests coming. Everybody is here to get scared, and that is going to be exactly what we do for them tonight.
I know. Well, I'm going to go on the trail, so we'll see how scared I get.
Good luck.
Thank you. What else happens here at Frontier Town? Like, when are you guys open? Or, you know, when are you closed? Are you open year round?
So we're here from Easter, normally around the first weekend of April, all the way through Thanksgiving. So we are open for camping, a bunch of months of the year, and there's always something different going on. Okay. We have everything from Easter fun, spring fun, cruisers always are welcome here. Summer, there's never a dull moment in the summer. This place is insane. We have so much fun with the water park. We've got the Western theme park, cowboy shows, so much good stuff. And then in the fall, again, a lot more happening. We have our Halloween weekends, 4 full weekends of Halloween, which is crazy. We have
and
so
do you
much.
Have to have your own RV, tent? How does that work?
If you have a tent, you can pop a tent up. Mm-hmm. If you've got an RV, bring it. We've got hookups for everybody. But if you don't have any of that, we have cabins. We have bare bones cabins, which have basically are a step up from a tent. Mm-hmm. Or we have full cabins with kitchens and bathrooms, most importantly bathrooms.
Or air conditioning?
Air conditioning, definitely.
Okay. You know, I mean, it's warm here this weekend, but you never know.
You never know. Okay. And we have our Conestoga wagons. It's just like camping in a full-size wagon, just like they did back in the 1800s, which is very cool. Those don't have bathrooms, but they do have air conditioning.
And how does somebody book a site?
Yeah, so they can call us here, right here at the office. We are always here Monday through Friday, or when we're open, we're here 7 days a week.
Okay.
Or you can just go to our website and book a site.
And what is the website?
Our website is sunoutdoors.com, and then just search Frontier Town.
Okay.
You'll find us.
I got it. Okay. So with Halloween weekend, we have the Haunted Trail. What other events are going on throughout the weekend?
We have so much going on. We have a Halloween festival on Saturdays, which is really fun. We have vendor shopping, pumpkin painting, games. You never know what we're going to do at the Halloween festival. We have golf cart parade, candy bar bingo, trick-or-treating in the campground,
and we
have almost 700 campsites, so you know you're going to leave with a big bag of candy.
If I was a kid, that's a great strategy. You don't have to walk far, and you get, you know, probably a pillowcase full of candy.
So much candy. They get the most amount of candy here, definitely. And then we also have our glow dance party, which is so fun. Everyone gets their glow items on, and we just have so much fun in the pavilion.
Wow. When do you start planning for such an extravagant weekend? Weekends?
We start planning as soon as we close. As soon as we close the first night, or that next day, we're starting to plan for the next year. I've already got ideas for next year.
Fantastic. So you change it up every year?
Oh, yeah. We change it up every year. We still bring our tried and true stuff, but we definitely change it up every year because we like to keep you guys surprised and want you to keep coming back.
I hear you there. And then what about your staff? I know sometimes, you know, as seasons change, it's harder to keep staff. Do you have enough people for Halloween weekend? How does that work?
Halloween weekends, it's really great what we do. We partner with a bunch of the youth groups here. We've partnered with our National English Honor Society at the local high school. And then at another high school, we've also partnered with their volleyball team this year. And we're hoping to continue that. They bring us volunteers to help us work this trail, and then we donate a portion of our proceeds back to them.
So you're giving back to the community as well as providing an excellent opportunity to have a fun weekend.
Yes, definitely, definitely. And they bring their friends, which is great, and then they come out and have a good time too.
Well, I know a lot of my friends come every year, and they book well in advance because you do get full.
We do.
So if you're interested, make sure you do go to the website or call them. Well, Mara, thank you so much. I'm excited to check out this haunted trail and the rest of everything that's going on here this weekend.
So much going on. I hope you have a great time, and I hope you don't get too scared.
Thank you.
Moments like this, you're faced with an important question. If a ball lands in a cup and no one else sees it, does it count? You bet your sweet 5-iron it does. Somewhere to smile about, Ocean City, Maryland. Oh wait, he's still going. Okay. Nice.
Since 1988, Coins Pub and Restaurant has been serving up delectable homemade entrees with a diverse menu, all with great customer service. Coins staff is committed to the continuing long tradition of Coins Pub by respecting the old and embracing the new. Coins is still the home of No Mumbo, Just Jumbo crab cakes, and now features a variety of craft cocktails like the Smoky Bullet Old Fashioned. Come enjoy the rich tradition and fun atmosphere of an Ocean City landmark, Coins Pub and Restaurant, 28th Street in Ocean City.
Maryland's coast is truly unique, and you're invited to stay here and explore everything there is to see and do. Get ready to go on an adventure to view the wild ponies of Assateague Island National Seashore. Be immersed by beauty at the various art galleries. Book your tee time at one of the 17 championship golf courses, or visit the downtown areas to indulge in delicious food and shopping local.
Book your next trip today at visitmarylandscoast.org.
Well, we're standing here waiting to go on the Haunted Trail. And I haven't been on one in a really long time, so I am a little nervous, a little scared, but I do love this, like, exhilarating. We'll see what happens. I like that this blood on the Steelers jersey. Okay, so far so good. My palms are a little sweaty. But what do we got here? I don't like the doors. That's when it scares me, the doors. This is like Chucky. It has like Chucky. Being in the woods, you never know who's standing behind a tree. I think I'm on guard the whole time, trying to look like 360 around me. I don't like the gate. I don't want to get locked in. Okay, going around this corner is a little dicey. That really scared me. Oh my god, my heart is racing. That scared me for sure. Yeah! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Oh. Okay, let's move along. All this. Oh gosh! Now I feel like I'm walking into a club with the strobe light going on, but I have a feeling it's not going to be anything like a dance club. But here we go. We moved on now to the madhouse. So here we go in the madhouse. Okay, the circus. Oh gosh, I don't like clowns. And this guy, what is that? Luckily there's a screen there. Yikes. Ah! I don't like the looks of this one already. Really cool looking, but it's a little smooth. I gotta get close. I'm walking close to you.
Do not worry. If you are staying here at Frontier Town, you should have on your yellow wristband. If you are coming from Fort Valley,
/OCA.
We're here at the Haunted Trail, and I found some people who want to know, is this your first time ever walking the trail?
Yes.
Okay, first time to Frontier Town?
No.
Okay.
First time for Halloween, though.
Ah, what are you liking the vibe so far?
Love it.
Yes. Halloween. Picked a great weekend. Cool. I mean, the weather this weekend is unbelievable. Are you nervous about going in?
No.
Scared to death.
Shush.
I think it's going to be really fun.
I just went through. It's a treat, but it's also a lot of tricks, and I might be a little scared.
Uh-oh.
Have fun, though.
Thank you.
How old are you?
I'm 11.
What's your name?
I'm a man in the vlog.
Troy? Mm-hmm. Okay, Troy, are you excited about this trail?
Yep.
Are you nervous?
Oh, yeah. No, I got to stick my little bit.
Excited? Okay. Wait, you think you're going to own it, or you think you're going to be scared?
Oh, yeah,
own
it.
I'm owning it any day.
Own it. Yes, sir.
I'm owning it.
No one's going to pop out of the woods and scare you?
No.
All right. Tough, right?
They can't touch me. I'm tough.
Oh.
All right. Okay. Well, I'd like to be behind you because I was scared on the trail to see your reactions to some of the things. We shall see, Troy. Good luck.
Oh, yeah, Troy. Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
If you want your trade-in to be worth more down the road, then shop Toyota, the best resale value brand, according to Kelley Blue Book's KBB.com, for the third year in a row. On a $45,000 vehicle, see how these Toyotas are predicted to be worth thousands more than the average vehicle after the first 5 years of ownership. That's performance you can count on. Shop local inventory on buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Thanks for joining us for this week's adventures. Be on the lookout for all that Maryland's Coast has to offer.
Thanks for watching Maryland's Coast Adventures, brought to you by Worcester County, Maryland's Coast Naturally Cool, and by Ocean City, Maryland, somewhere to smile about.